you're taking your dirty
clothes. Oh, well, you were talking to someone else.
Well, and that's besides, I recognize.
Did you hear me? That was good.
Okay. No, I just shot that out of If I take dirty drawers, they may or may not be on me. I don't take them in a bag. Damn it.
So it isn't.
Huh. Cool. I knew it wasn't there. Both of them.
Watch out.
Are we going to have a dance
I
off?
Have a better thing. No, no. Easy.
You can do her.
I have a better idea.
Oh, yeah.
Three,
one, two,
add
three.
No, we don't have a
beat.
We go to
Anton. Anton? It's expensive.
No, it's not.
Excuse me. Dude, do you hear this voice?
Is that from smoking and drinking?
Well, actually, it's called throat cancer.
Oh.
Easy, I'm not looking for tears. I'm kind of comfortable with this shit. I've been in Sweden for 10 years. I found out 6 weeks ago. I've got a home up here. I don't want to die in snow and crystal mountains. So I come home.
Oh, good.
All right, now, cool. I've got bucks about this big.
Bucks?
Bucks.
Money. Oh.
Dinero. Oh, okay. Goddamn me, dollars.
Good. It's good that you have lots of money.
I didn't say lots. I just
well, this
comfortable.
Big.
Yeah. I even got weak enough to... Okay, Mr. Oncologist, I'm going to see you Friday. He wants to tell me about two things. I should stop these.
Unfiltered lucky strikes.
Thank you. They're tasty.
Toasted.
Guys, you've been around for a few days. Well, I should quit these. I told him, look, dude, this doctor over here gave me 9 to 12 months. All right, that's cool. I told him, okay, if I quit right now, boom. If I never walk in another room that's got cigarette smoke that's been in there for the last 13 days, if I never even walk in that room, will you give me 3 to 5 years? Fuck you, no way. All right, cool. Will you give me another 12 months? Maybe. I'll tell him, okay, fine. Let's say I get 18 months. I go through a year and a half of desperate drop to my knees. I will kiss your feet and damn near lick your ass for a cigarette. I'm not going to do that shit, dude. Didn't want to talk about chemo. Now I get to wake up in the morning and feel like a dope fiend heroin addict and drop to my knees and puke my guts out every day.
Right
for
the last.
No. Right. Excuse me?
Well, it's just intense, that's all.
No, it's just real.
It is real.
I'm comfortable with it.
That's good.
I'm comfortable. I cook speed and I shot speed for 27, 28 years. When I got back Friday a week ago, I went straight to APD and told them, look, I kind of appreciate it if you don't fuck with me. You know who I am, da 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 da. You know what I did.
Are you a drug dealer?
Excuse me, I cook speed.
Oh.
I had 4 folks on it for me.
Oh, that's good.
I'm not a drug dealer.
So what's next?
You don't want receptivity? What's next? I'd go back and see the doctor tomorrow, and if he wants to do this chemo, I'll tell him, kiss my ass, thanks very much, here's your $1,700, and I'll see you. Now, I'll tell him one thing and one thing only. If you can go in and whack something out, fine, I'm cool with that. Go in, cut the shit out. Short of, I don't want to walk around with one of those little boxes on your fucking throat.
Shaky on anything?
All that. No, beyond that.
Oh.
We're talking about the removal of the vocal cords.
Wow.
I'm not.
No.
Maybe it's kind of offensive. It's just my voice.
Hmm? Do you mind if I ask a question?
Let me check. Oh, fuck.
Think really hard. This
is hold it. All right. Can I do this, please?
Okay.
All right,
go.
All right, cool.
All right.
Wait a minute. I need your insight first. Is it cool if he asks this question?
Yeah, he's a good man.
Mm-hmm.
But what about...
I know him a little
bit. That's a little bit. Hold it. We're being a little bit too brutal right here. Too quickly.
I've only known him 6 hours.
You've known me 16 minutes.
Exactly. So I know.
So I see. I feel better. Thanks. Yes, that's your question.
Ready?
No, probably not.
What's different now that you know?
Now?
Mm-hmm. Are the days different or the mornings or anything?
I have 5 kids, 3 grown. My daughter's 12 and my son's 14. I've been to both moms since I've been back from Sweden, from Stockholm. I told her, look, here's how it is. Don't tell Amber Lee and don't tell Dylan. Let me do this sometime during the course of this next week. As a child psychologist and a kid freak, this is the only thing that's really fucking with me. How do you tell your child, look, we're going to be pals for 2 days, 10 days, 2 months, 6 months? I don't fucking know. How do you tell a kid? I mean, even 12 and 14. My little girl is a serious, serious, serious fucking gymnast. She's been a gymnast since she was 4 and a half years old. She's killer, killer good. We had a tournament here last year. I flew back. I haven't been a vacant dad. I fly back 3 to 5 times a year.
Well, even though I was really tired, usually what I do before I go to sleep is I stare at the ceiling for an hour and just think a lot, you know, and I just, like, thought about the whole night and just, like, stuff that happened, you know, like, the whole elevator club experience.
Yeah, I was just, really into it, really. I just couldn't, sometimes I forgot about the camera because I was just so into it, just watching him and listening to what he had to say. It was really kind of mind-blowing.
Yeah, I felt more like you just never know who's out there, you know, what you do could, you know, there's just so many different people out there going through so many different things. It's hard to, like, you know what your effect on other people is going to be. Made me feel a little bit more careful.
After Mike left, what did you think of him?
I thought he was an unreal being, especially when he got all the way to the end of the hallway and turned around and said, life is a continuum, it goes on. That was the best line ever. It was the best. And so when he left, I kind of remember looking at everybody and just looking around like, did that happen? Was that real? Just looking around going, whoa, my God, and like not believing it for a second, having to sort of like step back and think about it for a while before it really set in. It was unreal, unrealistic, or surreal. I don't really know, somewhere in between the two.
And how, after he left, how do you think everyone else reacted to him?
Everyone was talking about it, so they all, you know, they were all moved by it in some way, whether it was really deep or not. But I think he kind of shook us all up. Yeah.
Everyone was a lot more chilled out, I guess, because they kind of burnt themselves out in the elevator a little bit. And I was really tired, and I had a paper to write the next day, so I was really antsy, kind of leave, and couldn't really, like, but I definitely just, like, leaned back and just, like, waited for the night to end, kind of, and just looked at everyone and tried to, like, see what, how everyone was doing, and just chilled.